COVID-19 went globally very rapidly, perhaps too rapidly, causing considerable panic.
Is herd immunity more effective, or is containment, lockdown, and severe quarantines better?
The whole art world has been turned upside down. Everything was put on hold.
At the beginning of the outbreak, at least more than 3,000 medical workers were infected, and some of them unfortunately died.
A natural idea comes to our mind is how to use our knowledges and previous experiences to fight the COVID-19 pandemic.
Now we have a university campaign, combat COVID-19, hindsight, with question mark. And we categorize this campaign into the 5 directions. One is the cure the disease. The second one, control the infection. And the another one is a media role in this battle. Interaction with the society. Policy research. We really want to see what is our far side. And what lesson we learned? Did we learn it? And if not, how can we learn it?
At Hong Kong BU, we're going to host an international symposium. We want to bring together a diverse set of international experts into a conversation that searches for a liberal humanistic way forward.
I think we just want to set up a platform for them to share their thoughts and feelings via art making. This project is just a small start to investigate what we could do or what the art world could be in the future.
We aim to answer a key question, that is, how the disease transmits among different age groups in the major social occasions.
I was so interested in this time to see whether the Chinese media, they play a role to hold the government accountable, and also to fill the role to inform the public about the information.
Our project is to take positive parts of all these different approaches of governance, of policy making with regards, and create a model of governance that will help governments in the future contain more effectively diseases.
By using 4 social contact matrices and the next generation matrix to mathematically describe the contact patterns, we are able to quantify the transmission risks of the disease at different times and under different conditions.
I collected more than 3,000 news articles and focused on their coverage on medical workers. So after content analysis, to categorize them into different frame, like a propaganda frame and the journalistic frame, you can see a huge differences.
We expect that a better governance, a better model of governance, will protect mainly the vulnerable people in the future.
So we're going to bring scientists and philosophers to talk about various conceptions of disease, death, and survival from various cultural perspectives.
So far, we have collected over 100 pieces of works. It would be a good reference for them when we return to normal. We can see, that is what we have been going through.
Altogether, Hong Kong BU now, we estimate we have near around 100 project and activities. I really hope the BU researchers can work together as a team, use our unique strengths of combination between the social science and nature science. Certainly, we'll win the battle over the virus, but we also have to now prepare to build up a new world after this pandemic. The new science is what we should focus on.